In tonight's game between the Avs and the Oilers, Mikko Rantanen leaves the game after receiving a huge hit from Mattias Ekholm. Hi, my name is Dr. Stefan Wilson, and if you enjoy learning about the mechanism of sports injuries, then please consider liking and subscribing to the channel. We'll check out the video here today between the Avs and the Oilers, where Rantanen receives a huge hit from Ekholm. So here we're in the second period. We're a couple of minutes in between the Avs and the Oilers. The puck is going around into the corner, and what we want to pay attention to here is number 96 for the Avs. He's along the half boards here. His back is to us, and he's looking to receive the puck. But what he receives is that body check right there. Number 14 of the Oilers, Mattias Ekholm. He pinches down from the point, and then he lays a body check into the right side of Rantanen's chest. Rantanen then falls down on the play. That was the first replay. We have a couple more here that we can look at. And from this angle, again, we see number 96, Rantanen, with his back to the boards. Ekholm comes down, makes contact, and here we can see Rantanen. He's completely suspended in the air as a result of that check. He goes down. The first thing to make contact is his left arm, and then he crumples down on the ice. The third view that we can look at here, this is the best one. We see Ekholm coming in, making contact with Rantanen. Rantanen's feet are up in the air. His left hand is actually down on the ice here. We'll move it forward just a bit. Now we can see Rantanen's left shoulder down on the ice, and we can see the outline of his helmet against the yellow paint of the dasher along the boards. We can see this is the moment here just before Rantanen's head is about to hit the ice, and there it is. The force of this will... the force of the impact of his head against the ice is forcing his head to the side in some significant lateral flexion of his cervical spine. That's more than enough to cause a neck strain here. But with his feet up in the air and that intense impact of the left side of his head making contact with the ice, this is where the injury occurs. What's going on here is when Rantanen's head is accelerating towards the ice and then it makes contact, that significant deceleration of his head is occurring, but what's happening inside of his skull is his brain is, you know, it's soft tissue, it's bathed in a nice, comfortable bath of cerebrospinal fluid, but his brain is still traveling downwards towards the ice. When his skull stops, his brain is still traveling, and they're going to bump and meet each other inside of his skull. It's that bumping, that impact, that bruising here, that's what sets off the cascade of symptoms of a concussion. And we'll roll forward here. Rantanen is not comfortable. There he grabs for his head. And when Rantanen goes to get up, this is the most interesting part of the replay here. What we're looking at is Rantanen trying to get to his feet. So here he has his right foot and his left knee making contact with the ice. He has a fairly wide stance because he's not very steady right now. He is a left-handed shot. So he's pushing down with his left hand on his stick, trying to gain more stability and leverage in order to get back to his feet. We'll roll it here. It takes a couple of tries for him to actually get to his feet. It does take him some effort here. Remember, as he's doing this, the concussion is occurring. So he has, what he's experiencing here is an ataxic stance, a loss of balance, loss of motor control, and right there, he's unsteady on his feet. We can easily see that. We'll look at that one more time. Here he is, wide base stance. He's trying to get to his feet with the use of a stick. He is off balance. The referee immediately sees that, and he goes to grab him to try and steady him. And then eventually the athletic trainer, he comes over as well in order to assist in getting Rantanen off of the ice. When the concussion is happening, when the deceleration of his skull occurs and then his brain tissue bumps up inside of his skull, that sets off the cascade of symptoms. Here, Rantanen is most likely experiencing some dizziness, perhaps some nausea. He could have some blurred vision, and he will have to go to the locker room to be evaluated for an upper body injury, a neck strain, a head injury, most likely a concussion. SCAT-6 concussion assessment tool will most likely be used by the medical personnel, and hopefully Rantanen will be doing better later tonight. So Mikko Rantanen is going to need some downtime and some healing time. In my estimation, best case scenario, at the absolute minimum, he'll be out for about 5 days. Hopefully he will make a full recovery and return to action soon. Thank you for watching tonight, and please, if you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and maybe a subscribe. Thank you.